Welcome to this short video which will explain how to use the new faculty leave reporting application. It can be found on the Employees tab in My Portal. On the left-hand side, you'll see under a channel that says Faculty Leave Reporting, and you simply click on Launch Application. But before we get into that, I want to go through a couple of things that you cannot use this application for. First of all, if you're taking a leave of 2 or more weeks, you need to contact your dean to make arrangements. Leaves from online classes also need to be handled through your dean using a manual form. Full-time faculty who are reporting a leave from opening day before the start of school will also have to use the manual form. This form is located on the Human Resources Forms page and is available only for those situations. When you first log into the faculty leave reporting application, the first thing it's going to do is take you to your home page where there's a greeting and a summary of all of your various leave banks. It's conceivable that somebody would have both full-time and overload and summer leave banks. So the summary of the hours as of the last payroll run are listed there. Below that, you will see any open leave reports, and in this case we have two. The first one is waiting for payroll to process it, and the second one has been returned and is waiting for the faculty to go in and edit it, and you'll see the edit button here. The ones that's already been completed, you'll just see view. Now, to start out and create a new leave report, we're going to click on New Leave Report in the upper left-hand corner. Now you find yourself at step one of what is a four-step process. First of all, we want to make sure that you're aware that this application can only be used for face-to-face or on-site assignments. If you have to report an absence from an online assignment, you need to contact your division dean. First thing you're going to do is you're going to select the term, which is, in this case, winter at De Anza. And then you have a list of divisions. And so the division that this instructor works for is social sciences, and you're also selecting the dean who will be approving the leave report. In the start of absence box, when you click, you get a nice little date picker, and this select the first day of the absence. It's only a one-day absence. That's all you need to do. If it's multiple days, then you're going to click in that end of absence box and select the final day. At the bottom, you have two options, back to home, which will basically throw out everything you've done, or click the start key. Takes us to step two. At the top of the form, you'll see all the information that you collected on the prior page. The instructor, the division, the approver, the dates of the leave. But I want you to pay particular attention to the originator field. Now, this field is designed to show you who actually created the report. Division-initiated leave reports are in accordance with Article 16.36 of the Faculty Agreement, which states that a leave report can be created by the division to cover an absence which is not reported within 10 days after returning from an absence. The instructor will receive an email notification that the leave report was created. She or he has 3 days to accept or revise the report. If there is no action on it, it is considered accepted after 3 days. If you scroll down below the header information, you'll see the 2 days that are listed on this report. And for each day, all of the face-to-face classes are listed. Online classes are not included. So in the first case, he is teaching one overload class and one regular load class, actually, for both days. You'll notice that for each class, it gives you the title of the class, the CRN, when it starts, when it ends, the hours that are scheduled, and by default, we copy those hours into the absent box, and we also, by default, check the substitute box. Now, if you don't have a substitute for an entire day, rather than going and unchecking each box, another option is to click the No Substitute button, which I'll do here, and that removes it. So for this fictional instructor, he was able to teach his first class. So he was not absent for that first class, and the hours absence need to be changed to zero. But he was absent for the second class on that day. No substitute, we've already removed the button. And so now we have to select the reason for the absence. The drop-down list is going to display valid reasons for part-time or full-time faculty, depending on which one you are. So it'll only give you valid reasons. And in this case, he got sick. And we have a couple of other little helpful buttons. If you have multiple classes on one day and you want to just copy the reason, you can use this button. If you want to copy that reason to the entire report, you can use the second button. So that's what I'm going to do here. So I now have sick leave for part of the day on Monday and for all day on Tuesday. You'll see down at the bottom under the estimated deductions that for full-time sick, he has been docked 16 hours. And in that case, that's because he has one regular load class, which counts as 100% of an 8-hour day. So he missed it on both days, and that's 16 hours. Now, the overload class on the first day, he didn't miss it. On the second day, he missed the overload class, which again is 100% of an 8-hour day, and he was docked the 8-hour overload sick time. I know it's a little confusing, but if you think about it, you're going to earn your sick time 8 hours at a time for overload, another 8 hours for regular load. So once you finish this, you have an additional option. You, again, can cancel it, throw it away. You can save it for later. And when you save it for later, it'll show up on that home page where you'll be able to click on the edit button and go in and finish it later. Or you can click next. Before we go on to step three, I want to take a look at TBA classes. Those are to-be-arranged classes that have been assigned a set number of hours per week, but not a set time when the class will be held. TBA classes will be listed on the leave report with zero schedule hours. However, if you miss an arranged TBA session and don't make it up that week, you're required to enter the hours missed. As an example, we have Jimmy, who is the ping pong coach. He has practice Monday and Wednesday and Friday afternoons for 2 hours. On Monday, he's out sick and cancels the practice. If he does not reschedule the practice for another day that week, he needs to enter 2 hours absent for Monday. If he does reschedule, then he can leave the default as 0 hours absent. If you need some more information on this, please refer to the FAQ on how to handle partial day absences. Step three is where you will select a substitute. Now, if you're absent and there is no substitute, you get to go directly to step four. But in this example, we have a substitute. And in fact, we have a substitute for both of the classes on Tuesday. And you can see everything's listed. The hours scheduled, the hours absent, the hours worked. And these, by hours worked, we're referring to the number of hours the substitute taught. So if you have a situation where you have a 2-hour class and you had a substitute for only 1 hour, you would change the hours worked to reflect the same number of hours that the substitute actually taught. To find a substitute, all you need to do is click in this box, and you can type in part of the first name, part of the last name, or you can type the department name. So we're just going to type in history, and we will get a list of all of the instructors who teach history. And hopefully the one that we used is on this list. Now, again, we have some nice little buttons. We can copy the substitute and paste it into a particular class. We can paste, this is copy and paste, or we can use that same substitute. If we did use the same substitute for all of our absences, we click the final one, which will fill the substitute in. And that's what happened in this case. So I'm just going to click it. Don't have to go in and select it again. And we're all set. Now, one thing you need to remember is substitutes need to be approved by the division dean. They need to be on the books as an employee of Foothill-De Community College District. You can't just go call up your brother-in-law and have to run down and substitute your class. It doesn't work. All right, so now that you're finished here, you can, again, you can save it for later. You can go back to the prior step, and you also have an option to cancel it. That's throwing it away. Or we can click Next. Step 4 is your final chance to review the report before you submit it to your dean for approval. Basically, everything that the dean is going to see is on this screen. You also have an opportunity here to leave a comment in the event that there's something that needs to be explained to the dean when they go to approve it. So it's a matter of entering a comment down in the comments box and then clicking the comment button. You do need to be aware that any comments that you put in will be saved in your permanent record. At the very bottom of the screen, you can always go back. You can save for later as before, or you can submit it by clicking the submit button. The submit button will then take you to this page, which confirms that it's been submitted, and you can click on the home key to go back to the home page. Finally, a word about where you can find some more information about this application. If you go to the district webpage, www.fhda.edu, and click on the technology tab, on the left-hand side, you will see the Faculty Leave Project. On this page, we have all of the information, FAQs, various and sundry things about the specifications, project team, key milestones, and all of the information, the 2 years that we spent putting this application together. So we hope that this makes your life easier. And the other objective of this is that substitutes get paid much faster. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.